story regarding the extension of the sanctions by the Congress in the United States. We were talking to Professor Alexander Azadgan out of California. Sorry for that interruption. Hopefully I have you now back alive and clear. Go ahead, sir. You were giving me your perspective on why this has happened and what exactly it means.
Well, first of all, Majesty, as you're aware, President Rouhani's expertise is in legal matters, so he spoke from that angle. Second, you have to keep in mind that both houses of Congress, that being the House of Representatives and the Senate, have for a long time been in the deep pockets of the Zionist lobby, especially AIPAC. They're getting a lot of pressure from these lobbies to renege on their agreement with the United States. This, of course, is completely illegal, as you mentioned, because this is not an agreement solely between Washington and Tehran. It's an agreement with Tehran with five other superpowers. We are hoping that our Chinese and our Russian colleagues would stand up firmly to Washington. However, I do have concerns about some kind of a back, you know, room deal being made between Moscow and Washington, especially over Syria, as you mentioned in your other stories, and that Iran would somehow be sacrificed amidst all these political settlements.
Well, tell me what it could mean. I'm sure you know about inside of the Islamic Republic of Iran what is being said about the JCPOA, that if the other side is reneging on the deal or an entity from the other side is not sticking to their part of the bargain, it's basically going to be null and void. What exactly would that mean in your perspective for Iran if the JCPOA is actually canceled?
Well, for starters, Iran has made significant sacrifices in its nuclear advancements, and with the hope that Washington would comply and that Iran would be lifted from these cruel and evil economic sanctions. If Iran is going to continue going through that, which, as you're aware, President Obama just submitted that bill for another 10 years of economic sanctions, Iran certainly has options, which is going back to enriching uranium. However, the Iranians are going to, in my perspective, the Iranians are going to watch Mr. Trump's actions very carefully. So far, everyone that President-elect Trump has selected into major cabinet positions are known and proved Iranophobes. So we have to see what happens with that. A few days ago, before my departure from Tehran, I had a meeting with the family members of nuclear scientists who have been murdered by MKO and Mossad agents in Tehran. And they're extremely concerned, they're extremely sad that the sacrifices that were made through their husbands, brothers, or uncles that were butchered, cruelly murdered by Mossad and MKO is going to be in vanity. I have to assure them that the leadership in Tehran is not going to forget their sacrifices and that they did not give up their lives in vanity.
Thank you so much for being with us. Professor of Strategic Global Management, Mr. Alexander Azadgan, out of California.